I was blown away. The dude's a beast. Just the fact that.
I've pushed my body to the absolute limit today.
All right, it's 6:30 p.m., April 10th. Last couple of days here. I've been contemplating signing up for a 100 kilometer run here, and I think I'm gonna do it. Now, the reason why I'm signing up for this is I like to think of myself as, you know, a hardworking, goal-getting individual, but, you know, recently just about everything that I've set out to do, I haven't been able to pull it off. You know, in April of this year, I set out to run a marathon, and I didn't even complete that. In an effort to get back some of that mental clarity, I figured that there's no better way, or, you know, there's not many better ways to do that than, you know, sign up for and tackle some insanely big goal like this. You know, normally when people sign up for these events, it's, you know, it's kind of fun and all that kind of stuff. I'm sitting here alone. Nobody knows that I'm making this video right now. I know this is going to be insanely tough on me. And I truly know that. Right now, as I'm sitting in this video, I've blown out my knee golfing. Document the journey as much as I can. I feel like butterflies in my stomach. 100 kilometers, never ran a marathon before. I mean, the training plan, they want 33 weeks. But I think I'm gonna spend 10 weeks getting over injuries, 10 weeks preparing, 1 week resting, and then September 10th.
1 a.m. I'm nauseous. Maybe it's the wine. I know that you are with your friends and I am out with mine. Are we being honest when we say that we are fine? Maybe I should call you, ask you about your night, but then again you haven't bothered. So really, why should I? Are we being honest when we say that we are fine? I've been feeling like we haven't been talking. Used to share our moments and stay up until morning. I'm about to lose my faith, give me something. Don't let me let go. We have so much more. I need you to make it out of give up. Make it easy to give in.
The main thing that I'm going to be taking away from this ultra is just when you think you're done, when you think you have nothing left to give, like just how much more you actually have in you. You know, last weekend I ran 30K on the weekend, completely destroyed myself, set out foot for the next day to do back-to-back 30K, took one step, there's a shot of pain that went up my leg and I was like, there's no way I'm going to be able to run at all. 3 hours later I was 30K done, so when I thought to myself, I was done, I can't run, my legs hurt, everything hurts, I had 30 more kilometers left in me. Most people have never run 30 kilometers in their life in one go. So, like, just knowing that as much suck as you're in, you have so much more left to give before you actually can't go anymore.
I'm about to lose my faith, give me something. Don't let me let go. We have so much more. I need you.
So, 2 days out. How are we feeling? What are we thinking? How's our mindset?
How are we feeling? Feeling good. Injured my hip running a couple weeks ago. Hasn't gotten better, but I don't think it's gonna be impacting the actual run. Mindset is great. It's hard to actually work. Like, you know, focus on like business and whatnot, because, you know, just like, it's kind of like overwhelming to know like what I'm doing this weekend. So it's definitely distracting, but I'm kind of just, it is Thursday today. I'm kind of just gonna let it distract me so I can shift my priorities to preparing for this as opposed to, you know, business type stuff.
20 hours to go. And for those of you wondering where I'm going to eat 20 hours away from like 100 kilometers, the answer is Denny's. Okay, we just finished up some Denny's. We had an amazing waiter. Like, we've had some troubles with the waiters there at Denny's in the past, but this guy was a fun guy. Loves his job. So now we're gonna go to the mall, pick up the last couple things, and we're gonna pack our bags. We're going off to Whistler.
Filled with gels.
Pit Vipers.
GoPro.
Packed with camera stuff.
Vlog humanity.
Something like that.
Let's fucking go. I'll trust you running shoes. It's real magical. Just
secret sauce.
Wear this shirt. No, but you just think like, okay, like a beer every 10 kilometers, like that's not like that. Probably this is gonna be 10 minutes.
It's all fun and games until you gotta actually start fucking running.
Eating carbs and drinking water, that's what I've been told to do today. Do this.
Pedals, I think they should be banned from society, but oh, they probably should. But a 100 kilometer run participation medal, like that's a little bit different.
Me and Robbie did about 30K in one day. That sucked. Like I was telling you, like that was one of the most painful things. Imagine that times three, and you're running probably half of it.
I know.
It is gonna be so beautiful. Like, it is gonna blow you away. I'm gonna play it pretty conservative in the beginning just because I know.
That's the thing that I'm trying to balance, because like, I wanna play it conservative, but I don't wanna leave anything on the table.
And that's the thing, right? Because if you play it conservative, you'll have something left in the tank to blast out at the end, especially running down Singing Pass.
Yeah.
What do you think when Dylan told you he was gonna run this race?
Thought he was a bit crazy, to be honest. I was not surprised though, I'll tell you that. Maybe a bit shocked, but also not surprised in one in one bit. So
well, no, I'm mic'd up, so I can just talk. So we got a sticker. This is what we're supposed to put on my drop bags. Shirt.
Those are fun leggings.
Last thing here. Okay, for those of you wondering what's gonna get me through 102.5 kilometers of running, it's true drop bags, not drop boxes like everybody keeps calling them here. They're called drop bags. We're using boxes because I thought that would be easier. Basically, they're two little things that you get. Most 100 kilometer runs, you'd probably get like four or five of them. Due to that bike race and a couple other things, this race we only get two. But basically you just pack it with like supplies, everything from like chargers, blisters, to like food and stuff. This is the first one? Shit. I've never done one of these. I have no idea what I'm gonna want or not want. So yeah, that's the drop bag. Okay, just packed the bag. Got the GoPro here, film it. We also got a mount to get some handheld shots with the GoPro. We got the sleeping bag. We got sweatpants. We got a jacket. We got a long sleeve shirt. We got a whistle.
Hey.
I got two in and two throws.
How did you first hear about the race?
If I knew what I was getting myself into, there's no way I would have signed up for this. Honestly, what I did is I went onto Google, typed in 100 kilometer run, and as stupid as it sounds, this was the first one that came up.
So tell us your name.
My name's Hope Wilson.
I'm Colton.
I'm Robbie.
My name's Connor.
My name's John.
Megan.
How do you know Dylan?
I'm his girlfriend.
My name's Paige.
I'm Addison.
What did you think when Dylan told you he was gonna run?
I was a bit shocked, but not surprised.
Can't say I was surprised, but I told him he was insane. I mean, I wasn't much surprised.
I thought he was obviously a little crazy.
Well, fear of failing this thing. Like, so much has gone into it. Like, I've sacrificed a lot. I've put money, time, like,
If I was to go through all of this and not complete it, like, I would be pretty upset.
I thought he was fucking crazy. I actually didn't believe him at first. I thought it was a joke. And then I was like, oh shit, like, he's actually doing it. And so then when he brought it up like a month later, I was like, oh, okay, he's actually serious.
Knowing him, he's definitely a risk taker.
I think he's gonna do quite well at it too, so.
He needs to do this.
When people are telling me that, like, you're a winner for even doing it, you're a winner for even trying it, like, I'm a winner if I cross the finish line for everybody else.
Going rain might be 22 hours, what's your over or under?
I think over, because he's just gonna want to enjoy every single second.
Under.
Under 22.
I think it's gonna be over.
He's definitely gonna go under.
I think over.
But we have to be realistic here. Like, what is it, 6,400 meters of elevation gain or something like that? I'm going over.
I think he'll be under. I think he'll be under.
Tomorrow's just gonna be hell.
I think if anything, I was taking his training more seriously than him.
Hopefully not too bad, because I have to drive him home on Sunday, so I want to make sure he doesn't puke in my car.
I expect to hit my quote-unquote limit before halfway. Like, I think kilometer 40, kilometer 50 is when I'm going to be like, I can't do this anymore, and on a normal training session would stop. So it's that last 40 kilometers, 50 kilometers, 60 kilometers, whatever it is where I'm going to learn, like, just how much more you have when you think you're done.
Should we go get bagels? I'm like, yeah, the man wants bagels. And they left, like Paige and Hope left to go find bagels. But I'm guessing the stores were closed.
Yeah, I doubt myself. And I'm too proud to ask for help.
I want when you see me beside myself. Last text from the coach, it's go time, buddy. All that hard work comes down today. Go out there and prove what you're made of. Remember to keep it slow and controlled, steady on the downhills, conversational pace on the uphills. Keep fueled and always try to remain in the positive headspace. You've got this.
Let's go.
Dude, I don't know what's going to happen to my shirt. You never know. But I'm not taking my pants off.
When my heart beats, when my heart beats free, take my hand in the middle of a crisis, pull me close, show me baby where the...
Just walking in to check in, it's fucking cold, it's getting real.
How many people do you have in that race?
About 120.
Pull me close, show me baby where the light is.
Hey.
How are you feeling this morning?
Good. Feel great. How are you?
Yeah. It is what it is. Yeah. Ready to run some mountains.
Yeah.
Good thing to wait.
Okay, I'll see you over there. When all these problems burn like hell,
maybe I just need a friend. Our grizzly bears over there, and they are hungry and about to hibernate. We used to go up there, but no longer. All right, everybody. We have 2 minutes until the start of this race. Who is excited to run 100 kilometers at Whistler here this morning? We are so excited to have you. Line on up over here. This is the start arch. Don't be shy. We have just over 1.5 minutes until we start. Runner 2070, you did not label your crop bags. 2070.
Good luck.
See you guys. 2070 to the tent right now, please. Also, whoever dropped these tents and a green grocery bag saying compliments is not labeled any Smith. 1 minute till go time.
You can go to the side.
All right, everybody. And everybody, please join me as we count down from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, have a good day! Taking the lights off, till you broke the pressure, and now you're stressing, thinking it mattered, here with you for hours, but it feels like seconds, it's only
Okay, so I'm like 10 kilometers in. I was trying to keep up with some of the guys out here, but those guys are just machines, and I was like, I can keep going, but they're gonna kill me by kilometer 50. Haven't reached the first aid station, which I thought it was gonna be kilometer 7.5.
Numbers or anything, guys? Are we good?
Oh,
you're good?
Okay.
Anything?
Or just a breather? Yeah, just a breather.
Okay.
First time you've been.
Yeah. I just mangled my hand already, rolled my ankle, boom, onto a rock, kept going into the bushes. I was running with this guy who, we'll just say it wasn't his first time doing something like this. And we were talking, and then there's like this fucking steep drop. Where he's got poles, he just goes like, yoop, down this drop. And I'm like, holy shit, I'm just in my Nike running shoes here. So I slow down. And then by the time I get down this drop, he's gone. So I start running in the dark, step on this rock, ankle rolls, fall, smash my hand on another rock, and then I keep going into the fucking bushes.
You're in the boat. So the uphills, like the fucking gross grind. Oh, I'm like halfway up Blackwell now. Feeling good again.
But yeah, you don't look bad. But I mean, you're only 10K in, so like, we'll touch base in a bit.
7.5 kilometers to the top of Blackwell. And then run it down the mountain. See you fuckers.
See you soon.
See you later.
Remember back in the day when you taught me to live and I taught you to pray. We went in the battle together, no matter the way,
we never delayed. Hope you're doing well. When he first told me about like running this and like, what does even 100 kilometers look like? And then he was like, had this in mind, is like, maybe I'll do it in 20 hours. And then I was like, oh, okay, then 30. And then when we actually started looking at what he'd actually be running, you need to calculate the slope. So we ended up having to FaceTime Robbie for some trigonometry. Would come and just betray me. Sick of playing silly games. You never love me anyway. You should not have let me get away, cause now I'm hunting for my prey. I'm
bigger, we're a kilometer out. All right, John, Dylan's 30 kilometers in. How we feeling?
Fantastic. He's doing awesome.
Good. Megan, Connor, how we feeling?
Fabulous.
Feeling great. Making good time.
On pace to do great things.
The uphill is just brutal.
I bet.
You should see it up there. It's like, it's not even like a hike. It's just like rocks. You're just like fucking climbing over rocks.
Okay.
Isn't that like one of the...
Okay, finish it off. Let's go.
Don't forget our notes at the next one. Can you record yourself reading them?
Yeah,
I'll
be priority number
one. You have to get it. Oh, you gave Megan a fist bump.
I will arise, staring at you from afar, analyzing every scar, asking myself how we got here. Remember, this is who we are. I am not here for revenge. I did not come to make amends.
We're heading into Whistler Village. We're gonna actually go get some posters and stuff for when he crosses the finish line. Frankly, we were quite lucky. Like, I felt kind of embarrassed sitting over there but they all had those little cowbells and they had seats, and here we are standing around Starbucks. We need to outdo ourselves, okay? We can't finish on a low note.
We are gonna give it the Dylan 100%.
Not here to repent for my sins. I just came here to win. I just came here to end. I just came here to fight. Show you everything you said I couldn't be. I became overnight. This for the blood, this is for the tears, this is for my pain and my plight.
But he is not like this. That's still him.
Yeah.
Like, still him, yeah.
Describe Dylan, yes. I would say, literally insane.
Literally insane.
Like, low-key manic, but like, yeah. In a good way.
Full of somewhat inappropriate, but sometimes funny jokes.
Yes.
Most of the time
inappropriate. Most of the time inappropriate. The things that come out of that guy's mind, like, what the hell?
Okay, so as you just saw there, I was told by another individual running this race that that big waterfall was clean, drinkable water. It was getting a little low, so I restocked, making my way up Singing Pass. I realized that these fuckers that came out here with their poles, you can't compete with them. Poles, like, shit. I should have done that. I should have had poles, but now I know, I guess.
Renegade by nature, child of the wild, wrestling with danger, right into the arms.
On the downhill? Okay, we'll keep pushing through. You got it.
Okay, so I figured it'd be time for an update. Since the last update, I've gone to hell. My injured hip and hamstring is completely shot right now. Uphill climbs are absolutely killing me, but the thing is, I'm almost at halfway. So,
fear ain't gonna save you, so run Sorry. For your life. Let the moment take you right into the
update. I've been without water for the last like hour. I had a super nice guy share with what was left of his one of his water bottles, but I'm super dehydrated right now.
Okay, two words to describe how you're feeling.
Nervous and? Oh, those are the words I would have used. Well, Woo! Excited at least.
And
I
don't know where he is right now.
So basically he packed the charging port, which I know he bought specifically for this race. He did bring the cord
just
for
told
it.
Me we're gonna run out of
so I got this very interesting text saying, my phone's gonna die. Like, what am I supposed to do with that?
So as his girlfriend, you feel a little nervous.
A tad. I'd really like to know what's happening right now, like what's going through his mind.
Some life advice.
Mediocrity. That's what he needs to learn. But he wouldn't be okay with that lesson, so.
He needs to learn to slow down for once.
After, like, you know what, when you run a 100-mile race, or 100-kilometer race, you know what you don't do? Schedule a meeting for Monday morning.
Oh my god, yeah.
Like, but, I mean, he's chasing greatness.
Walls can't contain me, nothing can chain me, unbreakable. No tears will I cry from my.
Just finished up. I think that's aid station. Honestly, I feel a million times better than I did the last aid station. Crushing the downhills and just literally getting fucked on the uphills. We're still in this. Road running shoes, no poles, no experience, against all odds. Dude, thank you very much.
We're doing ping and he's at Cheekness at the bottom there. So he's made it back up and over Whistler. Now he's turning around and heading up. He'll probably stop at the 70K mark pretty soon to pick up his second care package. Another 7 or 8 hours and should be crossing that finish line. Puts us around the 21 hour mark or so. So everyone's predictions under over 22 hours. It's going to be close.
I know you can't see me right now. I just finished the last aid station. Now I have what is arguably gonna be the hardest 8 kilometers, 1600 meters of elevation gain back to the top of Whistler. But once we get up there, calling the crew and I'm telling them that this thing is fucking happening. I can't believe I'm 70 kilometers in to this right now. So close to the fucking top of the mountain again. These last 2 hours without a fucking headlamp because both my headlamps died. Now, a super nice guy lended a charging cord. I got it hooked up to a portable USB. I gotta just handheld it, hold it like a flashlight. This is actually fucking insane. The grind. Okay, so I'm getting ready for the final stretch. Spent the last hour or so completely alone out here. Sketchy as fuck. 2:14 a.m. in the morning.
You are probably just about to finish the race, if not finished right now. I ran a 10K with you and it was just brutal on my legs, so I can only imagine how you're feeling right now. So,
thoughts knowing this thing is almost over?
It's a relief. It's been a very, very long ride. I'm just glad to now be able to like, just go back to normal. I know.
how much stress training for this was. So I'm excited that he completed it and that it's over.
Awesome.
And he probably went ran out of water and just getting up to this aid station on top of Whistler was brutal. So many people struggled. So once he got there, they took care of him. And then I showed up and I was like, dude, what are you doing? And he's like, I am so glad you're here right now. Aww. So we literally got him together and got his food in and got him. And then awesome. And then me and him, we went down Khyber together and instantly he was like a new person. Awesome. Yeah, instantly he was like a changed dude. Because he loves the downhill. His quads loves the down. It was the climbing that
that's
was,
what he, said
it, he was crushing him at the climb. So. So we, and then we split and then we caught up again because he would toast me on the downs and then I would always end up meeting him or bumping back into him at an aid station. And then we were going over the top of Whistler coming down here and he stopped to go to the bathroom and I was like, okay, I'll see you, you're going to cut. And I thought he was going to catch me coming down Singing Pass, but he just never came up on me. I was blown away. The dude's a beast. Just the fact that Yeah, he should be coming in soon. Are you guys tracking him or?
Well, his phone's dead.
Oh, yes, that was the other thing.
Yeah.
So at the last aid station, it was like, anybody got a phone charger? And he's trying to charge his headlamp and he's charging his headlamp while he's running. And then I guess his phone dead. I guess he messaged you guys, I guess.
I'm 2 kilometers from the finish. Last 2 kilometers are straight fucking uphill. I've pushed my body to the absolute limit today.
Remembered on the way. Addy fainted.
Oh, yeah. We were dropping flies about you.
Yeah,
the ambulance is right there.
Addy fainted.
Nothing to take away from your experience.
No, no.
Is Addy in the ambulance?
Yes. You really persevered through this.
Yeah.
Steve did say, emphasize as a matter of fact, that you are a beast.
Yes, he did.
He's like, that one guy shows up here in straight running shoes, no pulls.
But you still did it.
Phone's dead.
No change of shoes.
Headlamp's dead.
No headlamp.
Do you go back? What time is it?
5 a.m.
Holy shit.
I think
if I had poles and proper shoes, I would have knocked 4 hours off.
I agree.
I was getting passed by everybody on the uphills.
Yeah, Steve said you were a beast on the downhill. He said you just fucking.
Just fucking flying.
Quads of steel.
Not anymore. It's just fucked. You know how many fucking gels I've had in the last 24 hours? It got ugly at some parts. I was 7 kilometers out. I was looking at the ground and the whole ground was spinning. I just lied on the ground for 10 minutes.
How's this feeling?
The vehicle's up
in the coast. Here, I'll grab this. And I also chafed. It's just from running for so long.
Yeah.
What does my back look like?
We can look at it later.
You look good.
Oh my god. What the fuck?
You understand?
Yeah, I was did you take a tumble?
That's the
back.
Oh my god. So yeah, it's a big circle.
Well, it looked worse when you went forward.
It's chafing from the back.
Yeah. What
the fuck happened to my toenail? The musical bumps. Stupid. How long did I run for?
24 hours. Yeah, exactly.
It was gonna be under 24 hours and I got fucking lost for like 15 minutes right at the end. Remember that girl?
Did she finish?
No way, really?
Do you know what fucking got her? The musical bumps. You go up the mountain and then it opens up. It was fucking 30 degrees. And you're just hiking straight uphill.
Yeah.
I had no water too.
Oh my god.
So I completely bombed, like I completely hit the wall. I started drinking out of the lake.
No, you did. Good effort there.
I was so scared coming down from the peak, like just completely alone.
Yeah.
In like, Whistler, like just with nothing but a flashlight. Completely fucking alone.
Is that everything else you do in life?
And the thing is I was so like delusional too, because I was so tired. And like I started like hearing shit and I was just like,
yeah.
I got a lot of backlash for that comment on social media.
Yeah, I mean like everybody, nobody was shocked by this. He'd been talking to me about it for actually a little while before I think he officially decided he was gonna do it. And so I
shut the fuck up, you're ruining the
You just ruined my take.
Honestly,
it's okay. I only answered one question. That's what I'm gonna do because fucking Little Miss over here can't.
Start again.
Yeah.
Hold on one second.
And then it was like a month later when I started to realize like, oh shit, there's gonna be like a ton of elevation gain. And I was like, oh shit, this is gonna be 24 hours. Oh shit, I'm in Whistler. It's gonna be pitch dark. Oh shit, there's cougars and bears. Oh shit, the temperature.
What is it? You don't know me, boy. What is it?
Oh my god! How many times have you said it to me? How many times have you said it?
It's gotta be done. That can't include that in the video. Oh my god.
How many times have you said it to me?
I know.
Oh. You don't know me, boy.